Okay, so today's task is to replace the leaking radiator in this old piece of junk here. So what you got to do is remove all the screws for the blinker lights. There's two of them, and then there's 1, 2, 3, 4 screws to take off the bezel around the light. You got to do the same thing on both sides. Okay, so now we got to remove this front grill here. So there's 8 screws, top and bottom. Take those 8 screws out, and I'll get my assistant here to help me. It just pops right out like so. Okay, so the next thing there is 1, 2 bolts that have to come out with a 5/16 inch ratchet to remove the fan shroud. And then there's another 2 bolts here for the electric fan. And then there's a connector that you unplug to get the connector undone. And this hose, your overflow hose, has the mounting clamps on it that go to the top of the radiator inlet. Okay, so the next is 1, 2, 3, 4 bolts there. 2 on top of the radiator, 1 here, 1 here, 2 at the end here, and then this one's got to come out eventually. And 2 down at this end, and this one, and then eventually the torque here in the middle's got to come out. Okay, so once this top piece of metal is removed, it exposes the top of the radiator. Okay, so all that's left now is to remove all the lines connected to the radiator. 2 hoses, 1 stainless steel fitting here, and then this pressure fitting at the bottom. Okay, so next, you would lean this forward and lift the shroud out for the fan. And there's 2 brackets that go to the air conditioning coil. Little bolts that come off here and here. And you lift up on the bracket and just kind of fold it in underneath like that. Okay, so we've got the other hose on this end disconnected and the whole rad pulled out. So here's the 2 lines. There's a flex line at the bottom here that's got a pressure fitting, and then a brass fitting at the top. It's 19 millimeter. Now basically we do everything in reverse. Just put the new rad back in. Okay, so I got the radiator in here, the replacement radiator. And now all I got to do is put the rest of these bolts back in, put the front cover back on. You do have to remove the 4 bolts right here that hold this front fiberglass front crest on to be able to do this. So we'll check this out in a few minutes, see if it springs a leak. Okay, so here we are. We got the new rad in there. And we just put the new juice in her. So next step will be to start it, warm it up, check the rad hoses to make sure they get warm and the thermostat opens, and that fan right there should come on. Okay, yep, so we'll get to that next.
Hey buddy, give me a goof cold start.
Okay.
Okay, so just checking the old temperature gauge. I think you can see this. It is less than halfway, and she should be really good. So we're gonna take her for a spin now, and that's the end of this video, unless we spring a leak.
So thanks for watching. What do you got to say there, Bubbles?
Oh, have a good one, Ricky.
Thanks, buddy. Over and out.